Hello and welcome to cookingflavors.com. For today's recipe, we look at the preparation of a very delicious and yummy combination of a brinjal and mochkota curry. And here are the list of ingredients that are required for this. I've taken a kadai, added about 3 tablespoons of oil. This dish calls for a little extra oil to be nice and tasty and yummy. But if you don't like that much of oil, you can always reduce the amount. Once the oil is hot, I'm adding in just about half a teaspoon of fennel seeds. Once the fennel seeds bloom, I'm adding in just 2 small pieces of cinnamon and 2 cloves and just 1 small bay leaf. We'll fry and saute that a little. Now we'll add in a few curry leaves and a few coriander leaves. Adding them directly into the oil brings out their best taste and flavor. Now I'm adding in just 1 small or medium sized onion, which I have roughly chopped. We'll saute these onions really well with a little bit of salt. We'll have to wait for the onions to completely leave out their rosp. In the meantime, to show you, this is a mochkota which I have soaked for about 6 to 8 hours and then I have pressure cooked it for about 6 to 8 whistles till it's nice and soft. I've used just half cup of mochkota here. The exact English translation for this, I'm not too sure. Some people call it dry beans, some people call it lima beans. If any one of you is familiar with the exact English translation, please do let me know in the comment section below. Now I'm adding in just about 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and we'll fry that well. Followed by that, I'm adding in just 1 big sized tomato which I have chopped, and along with that goes in just about 1 teaspoon of chili powder. Adjust this according to the spice level that you require and we'll add in the required amount of salt. We'll mix this all well and we'll have to wait for the tomatoes to cook in their own juices and become nice and pulpy, and it should mash down well. Now when the tomatoes are 3/4 done, I'm adding in 1 tablespoon of ginger and garlic paste, or crushed ginger and garlic. Usually I add it after I add the onions, but this time I'm adding it after I added the tomatoes. This gives it a totally different taste and flavor, but make sure you fry the ginger and garlic paste really well along with the tomatoes. They completely have to leave out their raw smell. While the tomatoes are getting done, here I have about 10 pieces of coconut and about 3 to 4 cashew nuts that I have soaked in water for about 10 to 15 minutes. We'll grind this into a fine paste and we'll get this ready. Now if you see, my tomatoes and my ginger and garlic paste are totally cooked and they're nice and pulpy and juicy. Now it's time for us to add in the brinjals. If you get the nice and tender brinjals without the seeds, this recipe will taste really good, but I did not get them, so I'm using the regular brinjals and they do have a lot of seeds in them. Now we'll have to allow these brinjals to cook nicely because the mochkota is already nicely cooked. Now we'll mix all these brinjal pieces together with the adha masala till all the brinjals get coated nicely with the tomato and the onion masala. Brinjals usually don't take very long to cook and they don't need much water, but I'm adding just about less than 1/4 cup of water for the quick cooking of the brinjals. Make sure you don't overcook the brinjals and don't make it very soggy. They should still be firm. Now after about 8 to 10 minutes, my brinjals are perfectly cooked. They're not overcooked, neither is it undercooked. Just the right consistency that I want. And now I'm adding in the pressure cooked mochkota. Make sure your mochkota is nice and soft. Sometime it requires as many as 8 whistles. So depending on how soft you want it, you pressure cook it accordingly. Now we'll mix this all together. There's a little bit of water, if you see, still remaining in this masala, so we have to fry it well till all the water 98% of the water completely evaporates. That's the time when you want to add in the coconut paste. So now I'm adding in the ground cashew and coconut paste. I'm just adding in 2 spoons of this coconut paste and we'll mix this all together. You can also switch it off at the earlier stage before adding the coconut paste if you don't want to. But adding this coconut and cashew paste gives it a super delicious and rich taste and flavor. After adding in the coconut paste, just give it 2 minutes of cooking and finally garnish it with a few coriander leaves. Now this can be served with plain white rice with a spoon of ghee. Just mix it with rice and relish it. Or it goes even well with sambar rice, rasam rice, curd rice, or even chapatis. If you did enjoy this recipe, please do give us a thumbs up and share this recipe with your friends and relatives. If you are new to our channel, subscribe to our YouTube channel and post in your comments and suggestions. and hit on the notification bell symbol to get all our updates immediately as soon as we upload them. Till we see you again with another new and interesting recipe, thank you and happy cooking.